Jai Hind, my dear students. Today we are moving to another chapter in accountancy, recording of transactions 2. Recording of transactions 2. This chapter explains regarding the preparation of cash book in different modes: purchase book, purchase return book, sales book preparation, sales return book preparation, and journal entry. Journal proper. So remember, in this chapter we are going to learn more regarding the books of original entry. You have to remember, journal is the one of the book of original entry that we have learned in first, and here we are going to learn more about another books of original entry like cash book, purchase day book, purchase return book, sales book, sales return book, journal proper. So please get ready to watch the entire video. Don't forget to watch up to the end. Every accounts are prepared with the support of one problem with a detailed explanation. Moving to the cash book, it is a book in which all the transactions relating to cash receipt and cash payments are recorded. So remember, normally business will record two type of transaction: cash transaction and credit transaction. And through the preparation of cash book, only cash transactions are recorded. It may be cash receipt or cash payment. So generally it is made on monthly basis, and it is very popular book, and it is maintained by all the organization, may be big or small. They want to know what is the total cash in their hand at the end of the year, or cash at the bank at the end of the financial year. So this is a book of original entry which is prepared to find out, which is prepared to find out the cash. And remember, single column cash book is there, double column cash book is there, and petty cash book is there. We have to learn as per the syllabus. Single column cash book records all the cash transactions of the business in a chronological order. It is a complete record of cash receipts and cash payments. When all the receipts and payments are made in cash by a business organization, only the cash book contains the amounts column. Only one cash amount column will be there. In the debit side, it will be showing the receipts, and in the credit side, it will show the payment. So my dear students, let us learn the format of single column cash book. Just look at the debit side. All the receipts are recorded, and in the credit side, all the payments are recorded. Remember, all the cash receipts are recorded in the debit side, and cash payments are recorded in the credit side. And don't forget to do the problem. From the following transactions, we have to prepare the single column cash book. Cash in hand shows the opening balance. Cash received from Banu will be recorded in the debit side. Rent paid, it will be recorded in the credit side. Purchased goods, Murari for cash, 6,000. It is recorded in the credit side. It is an expense. Sold goods for cash, it is a receipt, recorded in the debit side. Purchased stationery, it is an expense and payment, shown on the credit side. Cash paid to Rahul, 2,000. It will be recorded in the payment side, credit side. Paid salary and paid rent, all the things are shown on the credit side. Let us look at the format. And just remember, the opening balance brought down, that is 12,000. And it is, remember, cash in hand, 12,000 is taken as opening balance. And what about the next transaction? Cash received from Banu, 4,000. It will be recorded to Banu, 4,000. and rent paid 2000. It is a payment to be shown on the credit side. And purchased goods 6000, purchases 6000. Sold goods, it will be in the debit side, sales 9000. Purchased stationery 3000, so buy stationery 300. Okay, cash paid to Rahul 2000, Rahul 2000. Salary and rent, by salary 1000, by rent 500. After this, we are finding the total of the cash account. When we calculate the debit side, there is 25,000 and there is a shortage of 13,200. That is balance carry down. Balance carry down, it will be written in the debit side to balance brought down for the next year, 13,200. So remember, that is the way to prepare the cash book in single column cash book method. Remember, one more transaction. From this question, we have to prepare the single or simple column cash book. Cash in hand is there, opening balance. Look at the solution. By two balance brought down 12,500. Cash paid to Hari 600. It will be written as by Hari 600. Purchased goods 800. By purchase 800. Cash received from Amit 1960. So to Amit 1960. Sold goods for cash 800. Sales to sales 800. And paid to Manish 590. By Manish 590. And paid cartage 100. Paid salary 1000. Both are coming in the payment side. So cartage 100. Salary 1000. And at the end of the month, we are calculating the total in the debit side 15,260. And in the credit side, there is a shortage of 12,170. That is the balancing figure. Balance carry down, there we have to write. So this is the way, my dear students, you have to keep in mind. All the items in the debit side shows receipts and the credit side shows the payment. Here we are preparing the single column cash book. Moving to the double column cash book area. Here the amount, what is the variation between single column and the double column? In double column cash book, there will be two different amount columns. One amount column for cash transaction and another amount column for bank transaction. So that is the thing. A two column cash book is one in which there are two columns on each side, two amount columns in each side. One is used to record the cash transaction. The second is used to record the bank transaction or discount. When a trader keeps a bank account, it becomes necessary to record the amounts deposited into bank and withdrawal from the bank. There comes the concept of contra entry. One transaction, normally we are recording one transaction only one side of cash book. Sometimes, like the transactions, cash deposit into bank and cash withdrawn from bank will bring record of amounts in both side of cash book, debit side and credit side. There we will write contra entry. Contra entry means one transaction is recorded in the different sides of same account. Here in cash book, we are recording these type of transactions like opened a bank account or amount deposited into bank and a withdrawal from bank, like that. moving to the preparation of double column cash book, we have to, before that we have to remember the format. Just look at that, only a small change, one more additional column comes, that is bank column. Bank column comes in the credit side and the debit side. That is the change. So we will learn the concept of double column cash book by preparing an account. So my dear students, from this problem we have to prepare the double column cash book. Let us begin with the first transaction. Started business with the cash 1,20,000. You know very well, cash account at 2 capital is the entry. So we have to remember every time what is the journal entry, what is the rule and what is the journal entry. So we will record that item in the debit side to capital 1,20,000. Look at this, one account column is cash and another amount column is bank. Both are coming in the debit and credit side. So what about the previous transaction? Started business with the cash 1,20,000. We have recorded in the debit side capital to capital 1,20,000. The next one is cash paid to bank. Cash paid into bank 50,000. That means cash deposited into bank 50,000. And this is the case what we have discussed, contra entry. Contra entry. Contra entry in the sense, the cash is deposited into bank. What is happening for the firm? Firm's bank account increases, but firm's cash account decreases. So in this, only in this cash book we can record that changes happening for cash and bank account. So we have to record it very carefully. You can watch a C mark in the ledger folio column. Just look at the date of transaction, December 3 in the credit side and December 3 in the debit side. And what is the entry? Bank account at 2 cash, that is the entry, general entry. How we are recording? In the credit side, by bank we are writing. Bank account at 2 cash, that is the entry. So by bank, and look at that, amount is written in the cash column because that indicates amount of cash is decreasing. Why it is decreasing? Because it is deposited into bank. So we will write in the particular column bank, and amount will be written in the cash column. That is the highlight. You have to remember that. That means cash of that company is decreasing. But in the bank account column, just look at in the debit side, we are writing cash. Entry is what? Bank account at 2 cash. So 2 cash, the amount is returned in the bank column. That means it is debited, means amount of the company's bank account increases. Amount of the company's bank account increases. So from one transaction, we recorded 2 items in one debit side and another one in the credit side. So that is the thing you have to remember very carefully. So that type of transactions comes like cash deposited into bank, cash paid into bank, cash withdrawn from bank. Purchased goods from Sushmita 20,000. You have to be very careful every time. The cash book, whether it is single column or double column, we have to be very careful. We are recording only cash transactions. Just look at that. It is not recorded anywhere. December 5 is the date. December 5 is the date. Nothing is recorded in the cash book because it is not a cash transaction. It is a credit transaction. Sold goods to Dinangar, received a check of rupees 20,000. Sold goods to Dinangar. So we are writing in the column debit side to Dinangar, they received a check, so 20,000. It is recorded there. Normally we are writing, if deposited, if it is mentioned that it is deposited into bank, we can directly record. Actually, it is not deposited into bank. That is why we are writing in the cash column. When it is deposited into bank, then we can write as a contra entry. Some textbook give the explanation that only once when the check is deposited into bank, then only we have to record. If we are following like that, no need to pass this entry. Only we have to pass the entry on December 14. Actually, that transaction December 14 is related to the check received by the firm. Just remember that, received a check. Sold goods to Dinagar and received a check of ₹20,000 and paid to Sushmita ₹20,000. By Sushmita ₹20,000. Purchased goods and then sold a check received from Dinagar is deposited into bank. Normally, the transaction is recorded in business only the check. When the check is deposited into bank, then only the transaction is occurring. Here we are learning the concept like this. The check, when they get into the bank, we will write to Dinagar 20,000 cash column. When the check is deposited into bank, that means we are getting cash, isn't it? So in the debit side, to cash 20,000, the bank is receiving the amount of cash, and in credit side by bank 20,000. Nowadays some textbook gives only one entry. We have to write in the for this transaction for December 6 and 14, only one entry we can write also. Only one entry to Dinagar 20,000 in the bank column. Normally we are writing that entry also. That only entry, single entry we are writing. So the next entry is sold goods to Rani. It's very clear it is a credit transaction. No need to consider that transaction. Then next one is cartage paid in cash 500. It is paid in cash. Suppose it is paid in check, paid by check, then we will write the amount. Only amount will change. That amount will be written in the bank column. Received cash from Rani 12,000. So for the 18th transaction on 18th, it is a credit transaction. Now we received the cash. So we can record the entry on 22. To Rani, cash received 12,000. Commission received 5,000. And drew cash for personal use 2,000. So that will be recorded by drawings 2,000. Actually, it is not a contra entry. No need to mark the C here. If it is a bank, withdrawal from bank, then only we have to mark C and entry will be different. So remember, then we are finding out the totals. 1,57,000 in cash column and 70,000 in bank column. When we find the balance, there will be no amount in the bank account as credit, only balance 70,000. But the cash balance is 64,500. So remember, in this way we have to prepare the double column cash book. Remember how to prepare the double column cash book. And one more thing I would like to clear. Sometimes we have to, if you are going to the higher studies, then you have to learn double column cash book in different other format. Like now we prepare the double column cash book with the cash and bank column. sometimes we can prepare the cash book with the cash and discount column, double column cash book. We can prepare with the cash and discount column or bank and discount column. And another format of preparing cash book is, the cash book is prepared in triple column. Triple column means in debit side there will be three amount column, one cash, another for bank, and third one for the discount. In the debit and credit side there will be three amount columns, that is known as triple column cash book, that you will learn for higher studies. Okay, so moving to another area, very important, petty cash book. Petty cash book. Petty cash book, you know very well, in a large size organization there will be a lot of bulk transactions, so the cashier will engage the accountant, chief accountant will engage in recording all the transactions having large amount nature. Sometimes he will forget to record the entry related to small transactions. So to avoid that type of errors, we can prepare petty cash book. Petty cash book means the cash book for recording petty expenses, small expenses, like the amount spent for purchasing small stamps, stationaries, books and other materials, and for paying for small carriage amounts, small taxi charges, like that. These are expenses which are incurred day after day. Every day it will be incurring in the organization petty expenses. To record such expenses, a different book which is known as petty cash book is maintained. It may be maintained by ordinary or by the impressed system. What is impressed system? That you have to keep in mind. Impressed system means, the system where a bulk amount is given at the beginning for meeting the expenses. After that we will, when we spend for a particular period and the financial period is over, then we will utilize this account to find out the balance. Every amount spent, it will be recorded separately also to analyze where we are spending more amount, So that is petty cash book. Remember, the amount, the cashier will get a bulk amount in the beginning to record all the transactions of petty expenses. So my dear students, from this problem we have to prepare the petty cash book, a small petty cash book. And they got a rupees 500 as the impressed amount in the beginning, and in that month January 24th stationery purchased for rupees 100, bus fare purchased for rupees 12, cartage amount is 40, taxi fare is 80, wages to casual laborers 90, postage amount is 80. So my dear students, this is the format of petty cash book. The first column shows what is the amount of impressed amount received, that we will write. So it is received on January 24th to cash 500. So that after amount received column, that column is there, particular column is there, voucher number, amount paid column is there. And from this area shows analysis of each payment to find out the amount spent for each item separately. There will be an analytical area also. So the first transaction paid for purchasing stationery 100, it is recorded in the amount paid column. Also there is a separate column for recording if there is several times they purchased the stationery, we will add a separate column. So 100 is there. Bus fare, it is 12. It is recorded in the amount column. Also conveyance is the column opened for bus fare, taxi fare, like that. Cartage is another item, 40. One column for cartage is opened in the analytical area. So rupees 40 is recorded there. Taxi fare, rupees 80. It will come under conveyance. So items having similar nature, we can bring under one column. Wages to casual labor amount 90. Nothing is there as wages. So it is brought under the miscellaneous column, 90. Postage, rupees 80. That is brought under postage column, 80. After that, we are finding the total, 402. We are finding the total, 402. And balance carried down is amount 402. Balance carried down, we are finding. How we are finding the balance carried down? 500 minus 402. Then we are getting the balance carried down amount 98. That is the remaining amount in the impressed system. That also brought on here. And the amount spent, it is cash 402. And we are finding the total of each and every item separately. We are finding the total items separately also. For what is spent for stationery, conveyance, carriage, postage, miscellaneous, all these things we are finding separately also. So this is the way to prepare the petty cash book. You can solve maximum problems at home to learn more about petty cash book preparation. Moving to the next area, it is another book of original entry. Here we are going to learn about the preparation of purchase book or purchase journal or purchase day book. And it is a subsidiary book where we are recording credit purchase only. Cash purchase is already recorded in the cash book. So purchase day book, it is another book of original entry which is maintained to record only credit purchase. Only credit purchase. Remember the word, very key point. What is that? In purchase day book, the book of original entry, where we will record all the amounts of credit purchase made by the firm. So purchase day book contains the record of all credit purchase. Cash book accommodates all the records of goods purchases in cash. And the journal proper contains those records. The entries are recorded in the purchase book from the source documents also. Remember, in simple sentence, we can say purchase day book is the book for recording credit purchases. And this is the format of preparing purchase journal or purchase day book. First column is for recording the date. Second column, there will be an invoice or receipt number. And third column, name of supplier with the items, whatever may be purchased. Ledger folio number and amount we will write in the last. So this is the format, please keep in mind. And another book, we are preparing sales journal or sales day book. In purchase day book or purchase journal, we recorded all the credit purchase. But in sales day book or sales journal, we will record only credit sales transaction, because cash sales is already recorded in the cash book. In sales book or sales day book, we are recording only credit sales. And the format of sales book is, date column is there, invoice number is there, name of the customer. In the previous purchase day book, there is name of supplier. Here, name of the customer who is purchasing the product and or to whom the product is sold. Ledger folio and amount. So every time please remember the format, it's very important. Let us solve one problem to learn the preparation of purchase day book and sales day book. So my dear students, from this information we have to take the transactions separately for the preparation of purchase day book and sales day book. So first of all, we will learn the preparation of purchase day book. Every transactions related to purchase, June 7 and June 15 on transaction is there, June 16 on another transaction is there related to purchase. Let us begin with the transaction in June 7. Purchased from Aurora Company, Nayak Sarat. What are the items purchased? 10 chairs of rupees 200 each, one table for 600 each at a trade discount of 10%. When they purchased, they got 10% trade discount. Let us look at the answer. Remember the format of purchase day book. Date. Here we can write invoice number, that particular column, or we can write the name of supplier, LF, details and the amount. Details only for additional calculation. Here we can directly, if we can directly write the amount, then no problem, you can avoid this area, details area. So what is the name of supplier? Aurora Company, Nayak. They sold goods, or the organization purchased 10 chairs of rupees 100 each, 2000, one table of rupees 600 each, 600, so total 2600, less trade discount 10%, less trade discount 10%, so 260, it is the amount of trade discount. What is the difference? So actual amount is 2340. And another transaction on June 15. First one is on June 7 and another on purchase is on June 15. Purchased from Hira Lal and Sons for cash. 15 chairs of rupees 350 each. 15 chairs of rupees 300 each. And my question is that whether we have to take this transaction or not. Whether we have to take this transaction into purchase day book. Remember, every time only credit transactions are recorded in the purchase day book. No need to take this transaction because it is very clear, purchased from Hiralal and Sons for cash. For cash. So that means it is a cash transaction. No need to consider in the books of accounts. Remember that. And another thing we have to keep in mind. Purchased from Phytek Chand and Company, June 16, 5 chairs of rupees 180 each. There is no discount. So we can directly record in the account, in the statement, Phytek Chand Limited, remember the date June 16, 5 chairs of 180 each. There is no trade discount. So directly we can write the amount in the amount column, 900. After that, we are finding the total 2340 plus 900. We are getting the total amount of purchase, credit purchase 3240. Total amount of purchase is 3240. And remaining transactions are there. With that, we are going to prepare the sales day book. Sales day book or sales journal. So on June 10, sold to Sudha Furniture Company, Agra. To Sudha Furniture Company. That means the name of the customer is to Sudha Furniture and Company. To Almira, 2000. Less 15% trade discount. So we are writing the format and recording the transaction for June 10. Sudha Furniture and Company, Agra. The name of the customer, to Almira, 2000. Each, so total 4000 less 15% trade discount 600. So difference amount will be written in the amount column 3400. And on June 12, the transaction is sold to Mira Mart for cash. And what is the amount? What is the amount? sold to Miramart for cash. It is a cash transaction. So whether we have to take or not, my answer is no need to take that transaction because sales day book also recording only credit sales. So just look at the statement. Nothing is recorded on that date here. On June 12th, nothing is recorded. So only one transaction is remaining. On June 15, sold to Ravi Sharma, Delhi, two dining tables of rupees 6,000 each at a discount of 10%. So Ravi Sharma, Delhi, two dining tables of 6,000 each, 12,000. Less trade discount 10%, that is 1,200. So we are getting 10,800, and the total amount of sales day book is credit sales is 14,200. So my dear students, this is the way we are preparing the sales day book. We are moving to the next area, purchase return book. My dear students, purchase return book is another book which is showing a book of original entry. As the name indicates, as the title of that book indicates, this book records, this purchase journal, return journal records transactions related to the goods returned by the company to the seller. That is purchase return book, because we want to know what is the total amount of purchase return. So in this book, purchase return of goods are recorded. Sometimes goods purchased are returned to the supplier for various reasons, such as the goods are not of the required quality or of defective, they are not giving proper utility, that is why we are returned. For every return, a debit note is prepared. For every return, a documentary evidence, a debit note is prepared. And the original one is sent to the supplier for making necessary entry in his book. So that amount also very important to find out the actual financial position. And this is the format of purchase return book. And remember, it is purchase return journal. Date, debit note number, name of supplier, ledger folio and amount. Let us solve one problem. Prepare a purchase return day book from the following transaction. Returned goods to MS Karthika Traders 1200. It is recorded in the item area and amount is there. Goods returned to Sahil Private Limited 2500. So Sahil Private Limited 2500. Goods returned to Kohinoor Traders, list price is 2000 less 10% discount. So if we have to calculate it separately, list price is 2000 and it is returned by deducting a discount 200. 10% of 2000 is 200, so final amount is 1800. Returned towards MS Handa Traders 550. It is also recorded. So nothing else we have to list out carefully, only the items returned, purchased items returned, and the total of this account is 6050. So remember, it is the preparation of purchase return book. Sales return book, it is prepared to find out the total sales return. Sometimes goods sold can be defective or of low quality, it will return back to the organization. Thus, goods sold that are returned by the customer or buyer are recorded in the sales return book. It is not worthy that the return of only those goods is entitled in the books that were earlier sold on credit. That will be recorded in the sales return book or sales return journal. So this is the format, and while preparing this book, we will prepare one credit note number. So date, credit note, name of the customer, ledger folio, amount. This is the format you have to follow. Just look at the question. From this, we have to prepare return inward journal. Return inward journal means sales return journal, sales return book. So first one is MS Gupta. Traders returned the goods 1500. So we are recording in the format by writing on July for the rate, and the amount is there 1500. Goods returned from Harish Traders 800. So MS Harish Traders 800. And Rahul Traders returned the goods not as per the specification 1200. So that amount also recorded 1200. And the goods returned from Sushil Traders 1000. Sushil Traders amount 1000. And we are calculating the total sales return account. What is that? 4500 is the total amount of sales return. So these are the books of original entry. Please remember what we have learned up to this: cash book, single column, double column, and petty cash book, purchase day book, sales day book, purchase return book, and sales return. Very, very important areas. And last, we are going to learn about the another book of original entry. Some transactions journal we are not able to record in the original journal entry, like opening entries, adjusting entries, closing entries. It is not possible to record in the books of original entry journal. So we are preparing another book of original entry with the title journal proper to record the entries like opening entry of an account, adjusting entries. We are going to learn. Already we have learned in detail, isn't it? The adjustments like outstanding expenses, prepaid expenses, all that entries are recorded in the journal proper. And you know, when we learned the topic trial balance and rectification of errors, when we open the suspense account, there will be one entry. And also if we are writing rectification journal entry, that also coming under journal proper. And also the entries related to transfer entries, like amount is transferred from one accounting year to another accounting year, that will be recorded in the journal proper. So remember, the entries, journal entries which are not able to record first in the books of accounts, it will be recorded in the journal proper. So look at this problem. From these transactions, we have to write the journal entries. First one is purchased furniture on credit from Kubir Furniture. When we prepare the purchase day book, there we can take only credit purchase of goods, not of any fixed asset. Not of any fixed asset will be purchase on credit will be taken in the purchase day book. So that entry also we have to return, write and record in the journal proper. So here purchased furniture, it is an asset, fixed asset, on credit from Kubir Furniture store. What is the entry? Furniture account debtor to Kubir Furniture store, amount will be 15,000. Amount will be 15,000. Goods for 6,000 given as charity, an adjusting entry. Goods for 6,000 given away as charity. So entry will be charity account at a to purchase 6,000. And you know very well it is deducted from purchase in the trading account. Goods worth 8,000 and cash 4,000 were stolen by an employee. Abnormal loss. Entry will be loss by theft account at a to purchase 8,000. Arun, who owed rupees 20,000, was declared insolvent and nothing was received from him. Nothing was received from him. So bad debt is the concept. Bad debt account debtor to Arun is the entry. Proprietor withdraw for his personal use 5,000 as goods and cash at 5,000 and goods worth 10,000. drawings accounted to purchase 15,000, to purchase 10,000, and to cash it will be 5,000. Provide interest on capital 5 lakh at the rate of 6% per annum, and adjusting entry interest on capital accounted to capital, that percentage amount 30,000 is calculated. Out of the rent paid last year, 5,000 is related to the next year prepaid expense. Entry prepaid rent account to rent account 5,000. Remember that adjustment entry. Salary due to clerk 12,000. Outstanding expense entry will be salary account to outstanding salary 12,000. So my dear students, these are the things you have to remember from this chapter, a recording of transaction 2. So for your higher studies, you have to remember the topics like preparation of cash book, petty cash book, and the preparation of purchase day book and the sales day book. So thank you for watching this video. Any doubts you can ask to me, and enrich your knowledge by solving maximum problems from this area. So thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.